What's going on, guys? We are back with another Madden 21 franchise mode, and this time we'll be entering the playoffs. You'll be entering the playoffs and we'll be playing in the wild card game. But with no Trevor Lawrence. So we're going to have a simplified game plan. Yeah, Jones is the third corner. Hell, just be a deep threat. But we did end the year on a 3-game win streak. And Switzer, just work on. Ryan Switzer has not been good enough to hit the field this year. I mean, he's been a fair enough return man. Wait, what? The Cowboys? Oh my god, they did. Because of a tie! Yeah, but offensively, we're going to have a simpler game plan, then we're not going to dial anything too crazy up. Like, we're going to have a... McCaffrey a lot. We're going to try to make, let's see him throw as... limited as pop. We're gonna try to make Locke throw as limited as possible. We are in Jerry World. Mike McCarthy.
AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas.
So yeah.
It's the NFC Wild Card round on EA Sports.
Winner go home is the mantra, and off we go. We're underway in this NFC Wild Card game.
Yep. Yeah, we gotta play smart, straight up. That's the name of the game. Play smart. Play smart and we win. Play dumb, we lose. And McCaffrey. We'll get the first carry of the game. Excuse me. Yeah, and we're gonna have McCaffrey playing most of the snaps. They're gonna try to dominate the line of scrimmage. And McCaffrey won't get the first down.
They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
And McCaffrey goes nowhere.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Clinton Dix brought him down.
On the ground, McCaffrey.
McCaffrey will hit the second level.
Gets it across the 50 and down to the 48. A gain of 13. It's a first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because
that's probably going to be holding.
As we're seeing so far, where that continuity is there, and you can see that holding. They're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers.
I'm Quentin Nelson.
Exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
And that's a loss of 7 on the first down play. Here's a give to Dobbins.
J.K. Dobbins tries to go Tries to hit the outside. It's a gain of 5.
While the training staff takes a peek,
Dexter Lawrence.
They'll give it up to McCaffrey.
And he's going to be met at nothing. The line of scrimmage and taken down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
And he's got McCaffrey.
And McCaffrey.
And they will advance this across midfield, but still well shy of the first as he's tackled at the 47. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a 4th down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10.
So the we're going to try to break through. If we can get pressure on Prescott, we give ourselves a chance. But yeah, but if we let them get plays like that, then yeah, we don't have a shot.
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a 1st down too.
And Thompson
got to get this back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it.
Was there on the tackle.
Brought down right at the line of scrimmage.
Gross Matos.
Gain on the play. 2nd and 10.
On 2nd down, it's Elliott.
And Elliott gets gain of 8.
And there we saw one of the downsides.
Fuck you, Ezekiel Elliott.
Because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier.
Damn it.
The band.
And that's going to be a 1st down. 1st down for Dallas. Dallas gave Ezekiel Elliott the C. Yeah, but we got to get pressure on Prescott. If he's... I mean, I'm not sure like what we're going to do, though.
Yeah,
I think this is where the play caller is looking at his play sheet and saying, grab that dagger play, grab that play and just finish them off right now, because I think they'd love to gain that big advantage early.
And nothing, but Elliott will get the 1st down still.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on 1st and 10.
Yeah, that
they keep on the ground with Elliott.
And Elliott
taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4.
The ball carrier.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is gonna go back down and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively,
yeah, but we gotta break.
Feel okay,
oh, shit.
Because you didn't let it turn into a bigger
okay
run, but the goal,
I'll take it incomplete.
That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Incomplete.
They'll be in search of 6 yards here on 3rd down. This is now the 9th play of the drive. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup.
And Gallup makes the grab.
And they're going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 18. His 1st catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a 1st down.
Yeah, because...
From the red zone now, Prescott.
What's his name is, Martin's guaranteed to shut down. Is almost guaranteed to shut down. Clark. Basically, yeah, that's gonna be the battle. Can Yeet Matos get pressure? Can Yeet Matos do it? I mean, yeah, if they pass it, unfortunately. Nothing.
And this will result in him losing yardage back to the
if we can.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big time.
And that's caught CD Lamb, touchdown Dallas. And they played this year.
Well, we knew they had the crowd on their side. Their defense has already made a stop, and now here's an opening drive touchdown.
Yeah, how about the defense making the stop? offense feeling their momentum that they've generated and turning into points on their side. So now you've got a team working
Switzer.
Together, and you got the crowd involved fully on their side in this ball game.
And in this playoff atmosphere, that 12th man means even more.
Jeez, yeah, he's a big head.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They've been a come-from-behind team all year. They'll need to do it again as they trail early in this wild card game. He takes this for 3 to the 29.
Okay. Yeah, all things considered, I can't be too mad with that run.
Be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
And yeah, this game looks less sloppy so far.
Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive.
Ooh, ankles.
Also like what the runner's giving us too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Give him 10 there, good enough for a Panther first down.
Yeah, but that's going to be our team during the playoffs, so we have to be good. We have to be good at running. If we're going to be a good team, then we have to. Then we have to be good at running football.
While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. On second down, McCaffrey.
And McCaffrey will get a gain of 6.
Cowboys here on third down, bringing in an extra defensive back.
And it's third down.
From the gun, it's Locke.
Bad pass and incomplete.
Intended for just.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one. Close quickly, and he'll force the incompletion.
Yeah, I think we have a nice.
Line up to go for it here on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Locke. Complete.
Damn it. And Dallas will gain possession.
Stop behind the line as he will not come close to the marker. So their first drive of the game already trailing, having given up points. A little surprised that they went for it, right?
And Elliott down the sideline. Touchdown, Dallas. 14-0 lead. For our game plan.
Are able to show off their quick strike ability. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Yeah, like, we have a good team. Like, I don't get it.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin. Their
we need
drive.
To make some plays.
And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your
it's
answer.
It's not like we've gone 3-0. And oh, my God.
He rifles one that's intercepted. He's picked off just shy of midfield. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
And 21. 21-0. Dallas up.
On second down, here's Locke. That one's
why do you have to stop?
T. Higgins.
Use your noggin. Play smart.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
Dump the underneath stuff.
Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey.
Yeah, like, this game ain't over yet. Like, we still have a half to play.
They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Throwing his lock on third down. That's taken in by Higgins.
We gotta go for it again.
And he's gonna come up a few yards short. Brought down at the 45.
So much about offense.
They force him to abandon the.
You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks.
Yeah, like we can.
Decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
First down.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Justin Jefferson.
A good pickup there, a 22.
And I don't think there's any question.
Oh my God.
He's going to need to hit on a few more plays like this. It's been a difficult first half for them, to say the least. And I do believe if they want to get back in this game, they need to start right now. It's kind of like making adjustments. If you try and wait until the half, it's probably too late. They need to get going right here.
That's gonna be caught by Everett and touchdown, Carolina. Proving they're not dead yet.
Gerald Everett, 31 yards, and the Panthers are able to cut into this lead. Down three scores already. This game was really in danger of getting away from them. They needed a drive like that, especially on the road.
Not only to calm themselves, but maybe tamp down the crowd a little bit, because everything was against them. As you noted, this game could have gotten away from them very easily, but instead, the calming drive, now they have a little bit more confidence. Okay, we're back in it. All right, we're ready to go. That was impressive.
And the defense now needs to reciprocate. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Come on, defense.
The ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
Straight up, like, Matos has got to win his 1v1s.
Break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the
like, there's not much else to say. And incomplete pass.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one.
Okay, yep,
they were just
they're passing the balls.
On third down, it's Prescott.
Prescott's just going to go underneath.
It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down.
Wait, whoa. Wait, why is the clock still going? He went out of bounds.
They would have wanted to. They forced the third down, blanketed the field with coverage, nowhere to go with the football, forced the dump off to the back, and even then, they closed quickly and got him down behind the line of scrimmage. You name it,
yeah, like, even if
well in that last sequence.
Their own 41. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do. And now this
oh my God.
My goodness. Picked up by Trayvon Diggs. And he will
make the damn throw. Make the damn throw.
Continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. And you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up.
Okay, now this is a must-score drive.
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. Locke trying again after the pick six. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Gerald Everett is tied in, the intended receiver. But it's going to be
second down.
We thought
we had a good chance to win.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield.
Okay, yeah, two minute warning.
And he'll get maybe a couple before he's taken down, as that will take us to the 2 minute warning. Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown of what's going on here in this wild card weekend. As we
thank God.
Inside the 35.
Thank you, Locke, for making that throw.
Takes it all the way down.
I mean, yeah, like, these are throws that.
And Locke throws another one. It's intercepted. Pick
Like, you don't know how frustrating this is. You don't know how frustrating this is.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line. Following the interception,
they're not even throws are that hard. They're literally like 5 yards. He's missing like five.
This offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. They'll drop it off to McCaffrey. And this will be a gain of right around 3 from the 7 out to the 10-yard line.
Like, how much easier throws do we need to give you, Locke?
First down completion only netted him 3. Second 7. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. Third down.
Yeah, like we are trying to come back. Hold on to the damn ball. Can you hold on to the damn ball? Please.
You never want to let him get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down. Again, it's Locke. That's going to be complete to his tight end, Everett. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. So not only do they convert on fourth, but they pick up 22 yards in the process.
And Locke's going to get sacked.
Go down, a Cowboy sack. Drew Locke, sacked.
Like, as soon as, like, it looks like we're about to get into the game.
After the sack, second and 19.
Locke makes Drew Locke throw.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. Locke's pass. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Locke working out of the gun. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that will be incomplete.
Yeah, like, okay, yeah, like, we got
it. Being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield.
There's no...
Make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case... The hit was timed really well.
Come on, boys, we need the ball back.
A 47-yard punt, maybe a couple on the return.
And Dallas comes down and scores. And that's the ball game.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off around the 27. And this one will be brought. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense get try to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Ref. Pass interference.
First down, but he couldn't reel it in. Third quarter, wild card round. Thanks for being along for the playoff ride with us. Here's second and 10. Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of
he can't make the throws that he needs to make.
Obviously this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you gotta do, you gotta kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions. The interception last drive, there he hits the reliable target. Well, offensively, that's a mismatch that you want. No escape for Locke and he'll go down. Now the offense back out onto the field as he'll take over here in the final minute of this third quarter. He's gonna look deep for more. It's caught at the 25.
It's too little too late though.
And he finally
straight
goes
up
down,
it's
but not before reaching the 21.
With the score, Cowboys.
One quarter remains.
Like, we needed those
NFC
plays earlier.
Matchup. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL.
No one
on
really
Sports.
Was making any plays.
To McCaffrey. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. A good looking drive so far for the Panthers and a first down.
Like, throws that I would expect Lawrence to make.
They look to throw. It's Locke.
And even Drew Lock, to an extent. I expect Drew Lock to make some of these throws.
Now following the touchdown, here comes his offense back out onto the field as they will take over with a first and 10. They go over the middle and it's complete to start the drive. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Well, you're not getting it from us.
Again here on second and 10. Flushed out right. He'll run it. He'll get the first. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. That one a broken play.
Unless we, like, a once-in-a-lifetime comeback.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. That time trying
like
to
once
find
in a lifetime.
And that'll bring up second down. Back to the air on second down. It's Lock. And that'll be incomplete.
And DJ Moore goes down.
Pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. The Panthers on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This is third and 10.
Maybe Lock.
This pass caught at the 4. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. Now Lock again.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the.
He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Gerald Everett.
Like, this was a game for like 5 minutes. Probably less.
Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. Flush to his right. And now here is another interception.
Yeah, desperation time.
And
that's 51-21.
So now we're in the final minute of the game in the fourth quarter as this offense gets ready to take over. Now a desperation throw deep to. He's got a man complete. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34.
As a coach, it's my job not to quit.
Changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. He's going to let it fly. And a big turnover there as his guys.
And Colbert comes up with the pick.
CD, this defense, man. He's having fun out there. Their season ends here. A tough way to go out.
And the goal was to not just get to the wild card game, which they did, but to win it. And so now,
but next year we're back with Trevor Lawrence.
They got there, had an opportunity, and for some teams, they have to lose games like this before they learn how to win them in later seasons.
That'll do it for us, for Charles.
But yeah, we're going to be back, though. We're going to be back. Anyway, that'll do it for this episode. Hope y'all enjoyed. Have a good one, and bye.